Hi everyone, it's Andrea. It's just a quick colouring chat before I go away to London tomorrow. Just wanted to show you something because those flipping colouring fairies have been on my book depository instead of my Amazon retained, and this arrived yesterday. Somehow, I have no idea how it got into my cart and paid for. I blame the colouring fairies. So this is a graphic novel of Dracula by Bram Stoker, which has been adapted and illustrated by John Green. And basically, it's a colour your own graphic novel. So it tells the story of obviously Dracula in graphic novel form. So it's a very short version. And you get to colour it in yourself. So that is going to be so much fun. I've got a bit of an obsession with Dracula at the moment. Bought a copy of a hardcover copy of the actual novel last weekend, which you'll see in a book haul at the end of the month. And the reason for this is I am currently working on a Dracula-based story myself, novel which I've been writing for a few weeks. So I wanted to reread the original. And when I saw this, I thought I've got to have it because I think that'd be quite a fun way of getting to know the story in depth. But I really wanted to reread the original to help with my own Dracula-based novel that I'm writing. So more on that if it ever gets done. yeah, there's not that about it. Anyway, so I'm going to show you what I've been doing with the Green Lady. I haven't done much colouring in the last couple of days because I've had a couple of book reviews to write, and I actually needed to finish reading the books. So I still haven't finished one of them. I'm going to finish it tonight, and as long as I schedule it, because it's due to go up. One was due today and that's been done, and the other one's due up on Tuesday when I'm out. I will write it tonight and I will schedule it to go up on time Tuesday when I'm in London, and then I've got a question and answer session with another author scheduled for Wednesday. So as you can see, I've been very busy with the book thing, and I haven't been doing much books because I've been too busy colouring, as you know. So I'm just drinking an orange juice because I didn't want a cup of tea, which is unusual. I usually prefer tea. So as you can see, I've done quite a bit of the Green Lady's hair. It is very, very complicated. It's very in depth. So I've got my Derwent colouring pencils here with all the various colours. I've got my Marco Refines down there, as well as my favourite Castells. So if I fancy something a bit different, I can carry on. So yeah, I think I've done most of the leaves. not all of them, but most of them. And I'm just sort of colouring bits and pieces here and there. So at the moment I'm sort of colouring this little butterfly. So this is, this is Scarlet. And it's Colour Soft number 110. I really love these. So I'm hoping to do some reading when I'm away, because I don't expect to sleep very well the first night. I can never sleep very well in a strange bed. Not the first night, anyway. And obviously we'll be travelling to London on the National Express. It takes about 3 hours, so 3 or 4 hours. So I'll have my Kindle with me. I won't actually be taking any books, but I will be buying books. So I'll be taking my Kindle. I've actually got some review books on there from NetGalley to read, because I'm starting to get approved for more and more books now, as opposed to before. You know, used to be that I'd get turned down for more than I would get accepted for, but I'm now actually getting accepted for more of them, which is great. So I got accepted for another one this week, so I'm going to put that on. I will take my notebook and a pen with me. So what I tend to do when I'm writing reviews is I write them in my spare time at work in a notebook, and then I type them up when I get home or on my breaks, and I email them to myself if I do them at work on my breaks. And if I do that, then I've just got to copy and paste them into WordPress along with a copy of the book cover. So I've got quite a lot of books to review, to put reviews up for, which is always great when you're away because you can schedule posts. It's just I've got these ones that I got from a company called Head of Zeus, who I do a lot of work with. Their books are really high quality, and I really like their books, so... I do like them. So... I won't be publishing any of the ones I've written for books I've read a while ago, because the problem is I can read, if I'm not colouring and I am just reading, I can read around 4 or 5 books a week. I average around 20 to 22 books a month. This is the first month that I haven't read that many. I know we're only on the 22nd, I want to say. I'm not actually sure anymore. I've lost complete track of the month. And I have only read, I've only finished 7. But that's because I've been doing a lot of more colouring, because I need to relax because my blood pressure has been high, as I mentioned before. So I've just been, trying to chill out in the evenings and colour and chat to my boyfriend, rather than sit and read, because when I read, I'm lost. I just sit and concentrate, and I don't talk to anybody. And I know that my Paul finds it very, very annoying when I'm not talking to him because I'm too busy reading. So I have been, I've been colouring instead, but that means I'm not reading as much. But I will read on the coach because I get bored on the coach, and Paul usually listens to his iPod, so I'll read or I'll sleep. I won't be taking my colouring books with me because we take as little as possible so we can bring stuff back, because I plan on going to Persephone Books in Bloomsbury because I want to go and buy some books from there. And so there'll be no colouring until I get back Wednesday night. Then I'll try and see where I am with this one. It's only when you start colouring it in that you see how much detail there is. And I'm just amazed at it. And Gwen has done a fabulous job on it, because there is so much detail on the flowers, in her hair. Excuse me, it's only when you start actually trying to colour it all in that you realise how... I'm going to turn the book, I'm sorry, being left-handed, it's very awkward. How in-depth it is, how detailed, and I'm off the page. Do that, there we are. Off camera then, sorry. That some of these actual flowers are. It's quite hard work, actually, to know what to do with some of them. I like this book. It's a really simple one. But it is going to take a long time to finish. Off the page again, off the camera again. It takes some getting used to this, doing this, especially because I'm left-handed, so everything's the wrong way around. It's quite difficult, but it's all right. So yeah, I'm still using my Derwents on this one. I really like my Derwent Colour Soft pencils. So I've been... recommended that I try the Caran d'Ache Neo 2 colours, Neo Colour 2s, which are like a watercolour crayon They look quite nice, so I might get those. I probably will get the Derwent Ink Tents because Derwent is a British company. So I do want to try and support, you know, a British company, especially with the way things are at the moment with what with Brexit and everything. I'm not going to get into political stuff on here because that's not what this channel's about. But all I'm going to say is that it is what it is, and we have to live with it, and we have to get on with it. So whether or not I agree with it's unimportant. That's what's been voted in. That's what's going to happen. Of course, now we're having a general election as well, which is, oh joy. The next 7 weeks are going to be just constant political broadcasting. And like I said, this isn't what that bad chance about, but there you go. So, two things that you never discuss in public, and that's religion and politics. So I'm staying out. That doesn't mean to say I won't vote, because of course I will, because if I don't vote, I've got no right to have an opinion on what might happen in the future. But if I vote and I don't like it, I can moan. And if I do like it, I can say, hey, if it's not what I wanted, I can say, hey, I was wrong. There you go. I'm trying to support a British company just because, not just because of Brexit, but because they are British and they're based in England. I'm in Wales, but still. Same as, although I do, when I'm doing my photography, I love Kodak film, I love Tri-X, and I like, obviously for colour, I love the portrait films. Generally black and white, I do buy a lot of Ilford products because again, Harman Technology is based up in Cheshire, I think. It's not that way anyway. British company. But again, I don't limit my choices art-wise to just British things because that would be very short-sighted. I do like I said, I love Tri-X. I love pushing Tri-X. If you have photography, you know what pushing means. I like pushing it to $1,600. No, you can't get a black and white, or very, very hard to get a black and white 1600 film. Before that, I always used Fuji Neopan. But yeah, so I'm going to try the Caran d'Ache Neocolor 2s because they've been recommended. But I will get the Inktense at some point because... But I really just want to get the next colour softs. I want to try all different things because, like I said, it depends on the paper and the picture as to which coloured pencil I like or which... brand blends better. You know, this one works all right on this one. But I think the Marcos might work all right on this one. But I don't know. I haven't tried them yet. So I love this. So it's payday soon as well, which is great. And I got, I think, one full week in work in May. Because obviously I had a day off last week and it was Easter bank holiday. And then, of course, I got 3 days off this week coming because we're going to London. We don't come back till Wednesday. I go back to work on Thursday. But then there's... next week is May bank holiday, and it's actually is on the 1st of May. May Day bank holiday. So I'm only in 4 days that week, and then I've got a long weekend the week after because I booked Friday off. So it's another 4 day week, and then I've booked Monday off, so that's another 4 day week. Then it's a full week in work, and then after that there's another bank holiday, and it's what we call the Whitsun week. Spring bank holiday, they call it. It's my orange juice. There's lots of different things happening. Oh, that's a leaf. I've missed one. I've lost my leaf. lost it. It's gone there. Where was I colouring? See, this is a problem. Well, there's another leaf there as well. This is when you start seeing things. There it is. Right. You do start seeing things then. It wasn't that one. It was the light green and the green. Hey-ho. But yeah, so it's quite... It's going to be a nice trip to London. Because we're going to go, like I said, we're going to go and see Frankie Valli tomorrow night. Frankie Valli and the Four Seasons. And I've heard, because somebody Paul knows, went to see them the other night, I think in Brighton or somewhere like that. And they said that they were really good. They was really brilliant. So that's always good when you hear that something you're going to see is brilliant. So I'm looking forward to that now, more than I was. And then on Monday, we just move hotels, go into the centre. We'll stay in King's Cross, in one of the travel lodges. And then go see Motown the musical. Because Paul loves his Motown. I don't mind, I'll go see anything. I just love going to the theatre. And then on the Tuesday, like I said, we're going to Greenwich for the day to go on the Kaisark and things like that. So, and there'll be some book shopping. So you might get some blogging videos. I might do some vlogging. It depends. I've got another 32 gig memory card somewhere. So if I can find it, I will take it as well. And I can do some filming as well as take lots of photos. But I've got to be honest, I've not been very good with my photos lately. I've not been... I've not been working on them. I got photos from nearly a year ago that I haven't actually edited. So, it's really bad. It's just laziness. I love taking the pictures. I don't want to do this. Oh, gosh, my stomach's making funny noises. I don't want to. Like, it does. It gets to the point. I really, really do not want to. Just another one, though. Do any, I don't want to do the editing because it's boring, but I got a roll of film from last June still in my tank. It's just, I will do them. At some point, it will be done. There's another leaf up here. Every now and again, you just spot them. That's how detailed this is. It's really difficult to spot where they are. They just keep appearing. So I have got some videos to put up, but I don't know when they'll be going up because I'll be away. Pretty sure you can schedule on YouTube, but I haven't figured out how to do it yet. So if I can, I might schedule one for tomorrow or Sunday, Monday, something like that, so that we can you can see what I've been up to filming wise. I've done an unboxing and I've got some. There's something else, I can't remember what it was. It's been around for a while. I've still got a couple that need editing that I haven't done, so. Whoops. Because I've got two computers. And the stuff I need for the one video is on the other. It's on the laptop. So I need to convert it. I will do that, though. I can just put what I need onto a memory stick and transfer it. It's just being lazy. I might try and do that tonight because I've got a video of my camera collection to go up. It's almost a year since I started putting videos actually on my channel. I was quite amazed to see. I think I started at the end of April last year, beginning of May. What's that? Oh no, not that one. So quite amazed that it's already a year. It doesn't feel like it's been that long. And things might be changing at some point soon. I forgot what I was doing. where was I? I was on the, here we are, on the purple one. Yeah, so. Ochre. She was ochre. Was it that one I was using? It was probably that one. I am, yeah, that's a nice colour. We're still decorating. I still don't have enough bookshelves. Now that's going to be changing soon, I hope. And there might be some changes on the channel, but it won't be anything major. It'll still be mostly books, some colouring. Lots of colouring, lots of books. Where's my pencil? There it is. And lots of waffling about rubbish, as you can see. So I'm just... There's some lovely colours in this set. I mean, you could do them all the same colour, or you could... Excuse me, make funny noises with my teeth while I concentrate. Really depends on what you want. It's just, it's such a detailed picture that I didn't realise how detailed it was. If it'll focus, until I started actually colouring it in. But it looks really pretty. And I'm actually getting there now. I don't feel like it's so huge that I'm not going to be able to finish it. Whereas at one point I was like, oh my god, how am I going to do this? Because it's massive. And what do I do with the background? Now I do have some pens here. I'm getting into them because I haven't opened them since this is the end. Some acrylic paint markers, a black one and a white one. Now I don't know what this is going to be like. I don't know what the tips are like or anything. They look quite fine actually. Excuse me. I'm just going to... Obviously, I'm not going to colour the backing now, so I'll have a look at it. I might do the backing black. I haven't done this again. These are from Beautiful Pompadour. So. It's quite a big tip. So I don't think it would be any good for colouring this in. Shake several times, but for one of the backgrounds there is going to be not necessarily on this one, but on another book that's quite a big expanse. It would probably be right. I might do it in a blue, a Sharpie blue. Doesn't want to focus on the Sharpie. This was just like 40p. I don't know yet. I'll decide when I finished it. So it's going to be a while yet. As you can see, there's still a lot. Oh, colours are spread. Where's pimento gone? Rose, brownie, pimento. There it is. This is a nice colour. Let's go and zoom in a bit. Oops, wrong way. Oh, we're zoomed in as far as we can. We're going to do this flower here, I think. In this sort of pimento. We'll do... So, yeah, I mean, I don't know if you've got any questions. If you want me to answer, there's another leaf there, look. They just turn up, you just find them. I told you that. Just let me know if you've got any questions to ask and I will write them down and answer them when I'm doing one of these chatty coloring videos. Because my friend George said this is the sort of video he likes because he can sit and listen to me. He says it's like chatting to you. It's like you're in the same room having a chat. So that's nice. Nice big news in the Marilyn world, and not so nice big news in the Marilyn world. Nice big news in the Marilyn world is that there is a lovely new book coming out in September by Milton Green. Well, technically it's not by Milton Green because he died in 1985, I think, but by his son Josh, called The Essential Marilyn Monroe 50 Sessions, photographed by Milton H. Green. Milton H. Green took some of the most beautiful pictures of her, including one of the most famous ones, which is the what we call the ballerina session, where she's wearing the ballerina dress, among others. And he was also a producer for her. They were business partners in the mid-50s, and his photos are stunning. And I've got some prints of Milton Green up on the walls upstairs. So that book in the UK is around £50. So it's not cheap, but it's not as expensive as some books. There's some books that have come out, depending on who they're published by, can be very expensive. The Taschen books, which I love. I have a couple of books by Taschen. They've produced quite a few expensive books in the last few years. There's one that was done for Bert Stern and Norman Mailer. It was a Norman Mailer book. It was a reprint of that using just the Bert Stern photos, and it was like about £700. Although they did produce a £45 to £50 version. I never got it because I wasn't that keen on Norman Mailer's book. I'll probably get it eventually. And Bert Stern's pictures, they're lovely, but they're not my favourites again, whereas Milton Green's are. And then they did a limited edition book by a photographer, with photographs by a photographer named Lawrence Schiller. And there was a very, very tiny version, a tiny book come out by Lawrence Schiller called Marilyn and Me. But it only had a fraction of the photos that were in the big version. But that was like $1,000. And it's like most people can't afford that, and they've never reprinted it in an affordable size. Whereas with the Andrea did the NS ones, they did. So it just goes to show. I mean, I would love that book, but it's so expensive. And I don't have like £700 to spend on a book. £50 I can probably manage. £700? No, thank you. I can think of other things I can do with that. It's practically a holiday. It is where we go anyway. Tenerife. While I would still love to get that book, it would have to be around £300 for me to consider buying it at the moment. But saying that, like I said, the Milton Green one, much better. Coming in at £50. So I've got mine pre-ordered already. I only learned about it today. And I got it pre-ordered because I love Milton Green. I love his photos. And Josh Green's a really nice chap. And the other news in the Marilyn world is that her Brentwood house is back on the market. It sold a few years ago. And it's now back on the market again. And it's on the market for $6.9 million. Which is okay. It's not cheap. But hey. And this is the house that she died in as well. So it is a very, very interesting building. I'd love to own it, but if I can't afford £700 for a book, I'm not going to afford $6.9 million on a house. Although if I had one, that would be nice, you know. But there you go. That's the way life is, you know. We can't have everything we want. So it'd be nice if we could, but life doesn't work that way. Some chap will probably buy it and demolish it, like they tend to do a lot in Los Angeles these days. The only thing we can hope is that it would be protected, because she actually died in that house, so it's quite a historical building. But you never know. So that's the Marilyn news. Any other news? Like I said, it's nearly been a year on BookTube for me, or, you know, publishing videos on my channel. I can't see. It's just BookTube, because obviously I do the colouring now. I've posted stuff on my Marilyn collection. And I'm going to be publishing a video on my camera collection soon. So it's not just about the books, though.
Most of it's about the books.
I don't know what happened there, but the camera switched off for some reason. Just said it had stopped automatically. Yeah, I know it'll keep filming until the memory card runs out. It might be that the battery's getting a bit hot. I don't know. I don't know when it stopped either. I don't think it stopped that long because I would have noticed. But so it won't be much longer and I'll be switching this off and putting it on later. So I just thought I'd come back and tell you that it had stopped. So far, we've got this. So she's looking pretty good. I don't know how long it's going to take me to finish because, like I said, I'm not going to get anything done now. After tonight, until I get back on the Wednesday. And next Friday is the 28th, is it? Yeah, no, 29th. Anyway, next week, I can't remember what date's which. I know I get paid on the Friday. Maybe that's what I'm thinking. How many days in April? 30? I don't know. Anyway, so on the 28th, Grace Fonseca's colour along is going up, so I will put a link to her channel somewhere down below. Oh, there's another leaf. So you can check it out if you want to. And now I've lost it. Oh, there it is. When that's been, you know, I'll leave a link, and it's not going to focus, to her channel, so that we can. If you want to find out about Grace's colour along, you can. I will be taking part because she is using great one of the books she's using, I don't know them all, will be Jade Summer. And I have quite a lot of Jade Summer books, and I plan on doing one of the vampires in my vampire book. Notice the obsession with vampires. Yes. So I will be taking part in that colour along. And mainly because it's the first time I've actually had one of the books that's been mentioned. Because a lot of them use books I don't have, and it's not because I don't want them, it's just I can't afford to buy every single book. I wish I could. I really, really wish I could afford every single book. But it's just not possible because, you know, everybody has limited resources, including me. So even though I buy loads of current books, I've got something like 5 Jade Summer ones, I think. So it's quite easy for me to do that one. And I can actually, I don't just have to do vampires, I can do, I've got the angels one as well. And I've got the Egypt one, and I've got Haunted House. Yeah, as well as vampires. And I've got the Delicious Desserts one. So if I run out, I can always do some more. Not that I'm going to say, I'm not going to guarantee I'm not buying any colouring books next month, but I've got quite a lot now to crack on with, so I might just get some Prismacolors. I want to get the Prismacolors or the Caven d'Ashenio colour watercolours, crayons, something like that. So that's what I'm planning on doing. I'm going to stop here because I need to get this this done and uploaded. And I've got to finish reading the Detective Daughter series book I'm reading, which is The Dog Walker, because I've got to write a review and get it scheduled tonight before bed. And I've also got to pack my stuff for London. So that's it from me today. I will see you, hopefully, Wednesday. As long as I'm back in time. Because I don't think we'll be back till about 5 o'clock. But I might just check in and say hi. So yeah, this is how we're getting on with it so far. She's looking really good. And I will see you all soon. So happy colouring. Bye.